Hey everybody, if you have excessive scar tissue anywhere in your body, superficially or even deep, that could be contributing to your pain, whether that scar tissue is actually near your area of pain or if it is, you know, on the exact opposite side of the body. So let's break these down for a second. So if you have a scar on the anterior aspect of your shoulder, that can cause nerves to become entrapped in that scar tissue. And when they're trapped in that scar tissue, they're not able to freely move, they're being compressed. And so they can actually build up what's called neurogenic inflammation, which is then going to send pain signals to your brain. And so if we have local scar tissue, we are gonna want to treat that or to basically improve the suppleness of that tissue because it's going to free up the nerves that are trapped inside the scar tissue that are contributing to pain. So that's one way that we can have pain coming from scar tissue. The other way is a little more subtle and it requires a little more understanding of the fascial meridians in the body and how bodies move through time and space. And that is that if you have a scar, for example, on your right hip from a hip surgery, let's say, there are fascial connections that connect your right hip to your left shoulder. Now, if you have pain in your left shoulder and you have a scar on your right hip, then it is possible that those are linked and that the scar tissue that is on the right hip could be causing basically a fascial tethering that is then pulling on structures in the shoulder, putting it into a disadvantaged position, which could be then contributing to overuse in a particular pattern that then causes wear and tear and that then causes pain. And so if that's the case, going in and just treating the shoulder can provide some short-term relief, even if that short-term relief is, let's say, 2 years following PRP injections. But there's a possibility that if that scar tissue that is contributing to changes in these fascial patterns, if that's not addressed, then we can end up still being in this pattern of scar tissue in the right hip causing alterations in how the shoulder sits, which can then increase wear and tear, which can then result in chronic overuse and pain on that shoulder. And so the way that I particularly approach scar tissue is with scar therapy injections. My preferred approach for that is actually going to either be an adipose tissue stem cell treatment or PRP. Both of them are gonna work well. I believe the adipose injections are going to be exponentially better because we obviously have stem cells when we do a microfat and a nanofat transfer. But basically the goal, what I'm trying to accomplish with those injections and what you want to be doing in whatever therapy you're doing for these scar tissues is we want to increase the suppleness of these scars because we don't want this fibrotic, really dense, kind of matted down structure. Even if we don't lose the physical appearance of the scar, if we can make that tissue more supple, then the myofascia, so the muscles and the fascia are going to move better with that scar tissue. We're also going to have less nerves that are actually entrapped and therefore inflamed and causing pain signals in the brain when it's more supple. And so if you're suffering from pain from scars or you have chronic pain that doesn't really seem to be getting better, even though you've tried a whole bunch of things and you have scars, then that might be something that you want to explore to help you get out of pain. See you later.